Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, helping you make home and hospitality simple. Do you have so many serving utensils that you're rummaging through the drawer because you're not sure which ones to keep? Are you wondering if you should put the tongs, the ladle, and the soup spoon in the same drawer? Well, in this video, I'm going to give you 3 tips on how to organize your serving utensils drawer. My serving utensils drawer is next to my silverware drawer. If you want to see how I organize this, I'll link the video in the iCards above. My first tip on how to organize your serving utensils is to group them by their purpose. Because I've decluttered, I have a drawer specifically for serving utensils. I have 3 other drawers. They're not as big as this drawer, but all of them are for prepping. Now I have a thermometer here. Obviously that's not for serving, but I keep it here because it fits in this space. And as you can see, I have all serving utensils here, forks, spoons, pasta, ladle. This is for rice. And then I have tongs. I have a space here. I'll probably buy another spoon either for rice or for soup. I have 2 more spoons that go here, but these are all the serving utensils that I use when I serve my family dinner or we have a couple people over for dinner. I do have a separate area where I organize my serving utensils because I do like to host large parties of 30 or 60, and sometimes I cater for my church. So I have a separate area for that. But all in all, this is decluttered. These are things that we use. My second tip is to keep only what you use. So how will you do that? I learned a method from Peter Wildback, and it's a perfect method. I did it for a month where you take all of your serving utensils, and you can even do the same thing for your cooking and for your prepping utensils. You put them all in a box, okay? And then as you use them, let's say I made spaghetti. I actually made spaghetti for tonight, so that's the sauce. So I'm gonna use this to serve. So now I wash this and I keep it in a separate bin or something. And then I also had cooked soup for tomorrow and for Sunday, and that will just stay in the refrigerator. But when we go to serve it, I will use the soup ladle, and then after I wash it, I keep it in this bin. And the same thing goes for if I'm going to cook rice, and I use that, and then I use tongs. So let's say I have here different tongs, okay? If I don't end up using these things within a month, then that's where I can look at these and say, look, you're not using it, or will you really use it? And then I can choose from here what I need to declutter versus just going through all of these and being a little bit more overwhelmed. So by separating what you actually use and going through that one box method for 1 month, you get to see the items that you're actually using. So after a month, you will see the utensils that you're actually using, whether they're for cutting or chopping or spiralizing, serving, you know, even like the strawberry huller or a citrus peeler or garlic press, all those things. If they are remaining in this pile or in this box, then these are the ones you're going to look at and decide which ones you're going to declutter. So I did that and I got rid of so many things and it worked out for me. So hopefully it's a method that will work for you. By the way, the drawer organizers that I have chosen are these acrylic ones in a rectangular shape. I have shelf liner and I've labeled each of the drawer organizers. This is a lime colored label maker. My third tip is to group within a group. So let's say if half of my drawer here were for serving utensils, I would put all the forks here, all the spoons, anything for pasta, anything for soup, all the tongs. So group within the group, especially if you have to fill up your drawer space more because you don't have a lot of other drawers. So when I go into this drawer, if I group within this group, I know that all the tongs are here. I know that all the serving forks are here. I know that all the things I need for rice are here. Those are my 3 tips on how to organize your serving utensils. Number 1 is to group them by their purpose: prepping, serving, cooking. These are all my serving utensils. Number 2 is to keep only what you actually use. Use the one box method for 1 month and you'll see what you're left with the things that you actually are using. And then number three is to group them within a group. All my forks are here, all the tongs, and they're separated according to their group. If you're new to this channel and you want more home organizing and hospitality tips, then hit the subscribe button and the bell notification, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye. All this time you thought we'd never pay the price.